Hey everyone, welcome to the second episode in my Differential Equation series. Today we're going to be going over useful definitions and terminology that we'll need to effectively communicate in the language of differential equations. The first key idea we'll be looking at is the difference between ordinary differential equations and partial differential equations. An ordinary differential equation only deals with functions of one variable. If we're dealing with a function of several variables, it's called a partial differential equation. The easiest way to remember this is that if you're using partial derivatives, it's a partial differential equation. It's common to abbreviate ordinary and partial differential equations with ODE and PDE respectively. Let's take a look at this problem. Determine whether the following are ordinary differential equations or partial differential equations. For the first example, we can see that we're dealing with partial derivatives since f is a function of x and y. We can also tell because rather than ordinary d's, the derivative symbol uses stylized deltas. I recommend you guys give the second one a go before I give you the answer. We can see that we're using ordinary derivatives, and f is just a function of t, so it's an ordinary differential equation. Once again, for the last one, I recommend you give it a go before I give you the answer. Notice that in this equation we're using the partial derivative subscript notation, hence this is a partial differential equation. Next, I want to talk about order. The order of a differential equation is the highest derivative of our function present in the equation. Let's take a look at an example problem. Find the order of the following differential equations. For the first example, you can see that the highest derivative of y is the second derivative. So we say that the equation is a second-order differential equation. More specifically, we could say that this equation is a second-order ordinary differential equation, but the question's not asking about that. Try giving this second part a go. This one does run the risk of being slightly confusing since we're working with a second partial derivative with respect to x, and one with respect to t. It's a useful tip to always focus on the power of the delta at the top. Here you'll notice the highest one is 3, so this is a third-order equation. Once again, I recommend giving this last part a go, but be careful with this one. Upon first impressions, you may think that the equation is second-order, but notice that the derivative over here is kind of factored out. We're going to need to distribute this into the brackets, and then we can see that this equation is actually third-order. Another key idea is the different types of solutions. A solution to a differential equation is a function that satisfies that equation, i.e., if we plug it into the equation, we'll see that both sides are equal. Thinking back to the first episode, I showed that the solution to y prime equals y was y equals c e to the x. I also showed that c could be any value and the equation would still hold. When we've got a solution with arbitrary constant, we call it a general solution. You can kind of think of this c like a constant of integration. I also want you guys to notice that if we graph a couple of examples with different values for c, we get a family of curves. It's also worth pointing out that in an nth order equation, we'll get n constants. Let's take a look at the following problem. Verify that y equals natural log of x squared minus 4x plus c is a general solution to y prime equals e to the negative y times 2x minus 4. First, we're going to find the left side of the equation, and to do that, we just need to take the derivative of the natural log of x squared minus 4x plus c. This derivative should hopefully be pretty easy, because we just need to use the power rule, and we'll get y prime equals 2x minus 4 over x squared minus 4x plus c. Now let's plug this into the right side of the equation. We can simplify the e to the negative natural log, since they'll just cancel each other out. And we're left with 2x minus 4 over x squared minus 4x plus c. As you can see, both sides are equal, so our solution satisfies the equation. Once we found a general solution to our differential equation, we'll need another equation to solve for c. This is called an initial condition. They typically come in the form y of x naught equals y naught. Problems with initial conditions are called initial value problems, or IVPs. Once we've used our initial condition to solve for our mystery constant, we're left with a specific solution. We found that y equals the natural log of x squared minus 4x plus c is a solution to our equation, but now we're given that y of 2 equals 0. Solve for c. We'll start by plugging 2 in for x. Y of 2 equals the natural log of 2 squared minus 4 times 2 plus c, which simplifies to the natural log of c minus 4. Our initial condition tells us that c minus 4 is equal to 0. We can raise both sides to the power of e to cancel out the natural log, and we'll see that c minus 4 equals 1, so c must equal 5. Now we found our specific solution based on initial condition. If we go back to the family of curves idea I was talking about earlier, if we plot the point x0, y0 from our initial condition, solving for a specific solution is equivalent to asking which one of these curves pass through the point x0, y0. Here you can see that we end up with the same answer, c equals 5. I'm going to leave this episode here. This video was much longer than the last one, but I'm still playing around with the format. Feel free to let me know which one you prefer. To summarize, today we've learned about order, ODEs and PDEs, and general and specific solutions. If you have any questions or spotted any mistakes, feel free to leave a comment. In the next episode, we'll be talking about slope fields.